What tools do you need for do-nothing gardening?
No tools.
You think? It's also called natural gardening or natural farming. It's an Eastern version of our organic farming that has actually spread around the world.
You sort of have to dig with your hands or persuade other animals to do the gardening for you.
Yes, persuade other animals.
So you sort of persuade that a fox who doesn't want a sort of den, but a rockery.
Well, in the case of Paddy
Field...
Get some
fish in and they desperately try and dig a pond before they die.
Well, fish is right. Well, in paddy fields, where, as I say, it started in the East, they use ducks instead of herbicide. They eat the weeds, the throttly things that kill the rice, and they use carp as well that helps purify and keep the water in the paddy fields good. Now, I've got some props for you, which is more connected with the principle of the gentleman gardener, which was a familiar 18th and 19th century pastime to be a gentleman gardener. You can have that or pass it on. There you are, and on your side, you've got props. Isn't it exciting to have props? Yeah. Physical, actual props. There you are.
I can see where we're going with this.
So who's going to go first?
Well, everybody's been given fascinating devices, and I've been given a bottle with the top cut off.
That was designed by George Stephenson of the Rocket fame.
Was it?
The first locomotive,
And it's to do with the garden?
It is to do with the garden. He was a very keen gardener.
What did he make most money out of, that or the the train?
I think the train was a bigger hit.
Right.
But he was a very keen gentleman gardener.
I bet he was really tedious and wouldn't talk about the train in interviews and would insist on talking about his bloody...
I feel you,
in many ways, it's the work I'm proudest of. Yeah, it's crap. It's just a bit of glass with no top.
But it would protect some seedlings.
You've got sunlight, I think, is an important factor here. The sunlight, because you've got glass. And what does glass do? It can magnify, Stephen, can't it?
Yes, it can.
Fraction with it, can't we?
Yeah, okay. Or refraction.
Refraction, whatever. Whatever, doesn't matter. Let's not get bogged down in that.
Yeah, quite.
We're here to talk about gardening.
No, I'm silly.
What's
hello. No, not... You found out... Look.
It's a saw.
It is. It's for a gentleman gardener.
It's got a concealed serrated blade. You won't get this through customs. I could play with one of these. I can't make it work, though. Why won't it go forward? It'll only go that way.
Well, that's how you start the stroke.
That's how you start sawing.
It won't go back again.
Have you ever used a saw?
I don't think it's designed for exercise books.
No, that too. David has a point. It's for the gentleman far... No!
I want to saw something there.
Yeah, these are long. I just want to say... these have been lent to us by the Garden Museum.
It works.
Oh, really good!
Oh, my God!
I'll tell you what, I really wish they hadn't made this set out of asbestos.
Brilliant. That is...
That's a very good invention.
It's for the gentleman who's walking along and he sees an overhanging limb of a tree or overhanging limb of a person, for that matter, and decides to... Oh, no! What have I done? No! That's... Oh.
It's only plastic.
And see if you can tidy it away, class. See if you can do that. It's my clever psychology.
Clever, isn't it?
Let's see if you're clever enough to hide that saw. Brilliant.
Well, that was great fun. You got any more?
David, you've got yours.
I don't know. I mean,
Yours actually is missing a piece. The Garden Museum, to whom we're very grateful for lending us these incredibly valuable artifacts, this would have had a sort of hat in order to make it like a walking stick, a sort of leathern thing around there.
Oh, so you could hold it like that.
You hold it as a walking stick, and then when you see some obtrusive weeds, you turn it around, and almost like a golf club, you...
Just a little hoe.
Yeah, you just hoe.
Yeah.
A little hoe. Yeah. Not in the street sense that's used in the United States of America.
Which is the sense I usually use that syllable in.
Yes, absolutely. So, talking of hoes, Rob.
Sorry, a fly landed on my buzzer and I tried to use my little hoe.
My little hoe. It's, yeah. it's a new sort of toy for children, yeah. isn't it? My little, so what's your little hoe for?
Well, I've absolutely no idea, other than I think it's something to do with light.
Well, it's not bad. Well, it actually forces a shape. What sort of shape would something in there have to be?
A bottle.
Oh, a vegetable.
It would have to be a straight vegetable, though, wouldn't it?
So, oh. Is it for cucumbers?
For cucumbers, for growing straight cucumbers.
Points, and I've mended my walking stick.
Yes! Points all round for Alan Davies. There you are.
Now, that thing up there, though, Stephen, it may well be for cucumbers, but that picture there is very similar to a spam email that I get sent. And I have to say, I'll tell you now, don't waste your money, it doesn't work.
Dara, what have you got?
I am guessing that you put a mixture of seeds in of different sizes, because there are little holes of different sizes, and then if you're the kind of person who knows what size seed you need, then you just sprinkle it.
You're exactly...
In the most effete gardening way imaginable. There you go. And we're in the company of which actual gardeners would be going, oh, well done, my lord, that's really top-quality gardening you're doing there.
I'm rather exhausted now. I think I may have to go in and have a cocktail.
I've had a fit of the vapours from my gardening.
So, do-nothing gardening, where we started, is small-scale organic farming with minimal inputs.